if you have to draw the image of some region in a complex plane, you need to be careful. If complex roots are involved, you need to be careful as well. So, in these exercises, you will need to be double careful because both problems are involved. So we have our function f from c to c. We have z to the power 1/2 for z not equal to 0 and f of 0 equals 0. Then we set our region g, the real part of z negative, norm of z smaller equal 3. And then, first of all, we set the argument of z to be between 0 and 2 pi. We have to draw the image of g under f. And then same question, where we set the argument of z between minus pi and pi. So, first question to you. Does your function in question A, have a branch cut along the real axis? Let's draw our region G first. So the real part of z is negative, so that's the green region. The norm of z between 0 and 3, that's the red circle. And we left out 0, we will do 0 separately, so 0.0 is a yellow dot. So G is where they intersect, so the intersection of the green region is the red circle, so that's this semicircle over here, including its boundary. That's what we will call G1, and then 0 separately. That's about the region G. Now what about our function f? Well, f of z equals z to the power 1/2. By definition, e to the power 1/2 log of z, e to the power 1/2 ln z plus I over 2 times the argument of z, all by definition. So you get the square root of the modulus z times e to the power I over 2 times the argument of z, where the argument of z is between 0 and 2 pi. Notice here, by the way, that we do have a jump in the argument along the real axis from 0 to 2 pi, but we haven't defined a branch cut or whatever. The function is now just discontinuous if you cross the real axis. So there's, in this case, no branch cut involved. Now, how are we going to find the image of our region? Well, you look at the boundary. So first we take z equals I times t. So that's this part over here, t between 0 and 3. Then our if you look for f at it, the norm of z is just t, so you get the square root of t. The argument is everywhere pi over 2. So if you take 1/2, you get square root of 2 times e to the power pi I over 4. So what you see in the, as an image, you get constant argument and norm between 0 and square root of 3. So you get the line segment. Similarly, down here, z equals minus it, almost the same. Again, the modulus of your function is the square root of t, but now your argument will be 3 pi over 2, because remember, we took our argument between 0 and 2 pi. Our function value will be square root of t times e to the power 3 pi I over 4. So again, a line segment, the size square root of 3, but now with a different angle, 3 pi over 4 instead of pi over 4. On to the third segment. So there we have the norm of z equals 3, that's this part. And the argument between pi over 2 and 3 pi over 2, because remember, the argument has to be between 0 and 2 pi. So those are the arguments. We can parameterize, we have z equals 3 times e to the power it with t between pi over 2 and 3 pi over 2. If you plug this in into f, you get f equals square root of t times e to the power it over 2, t between pi over 2 and 3 pi over 2. So we have a constant modulus square root of 3, and we have the argument varying between pi over 4 and 3 pi over 4, so we have a segment of a circle. N. Now we combine everything. The first part over here, second part over here, third part over here, and the origin map to the origin. And then, question, does our region map inside or outside the ice cone? Well, you can, for example, figure out what's going on by taking some points in here, like see what happens to minus one. You see that it gets somewhere over here. So the your region G is mapped to the inside of your ice cone. So you'll get the ice cone in this case. That's the answer to question A. Then question B looks completely the same. Will you get the same image region? Well, that would be silly, of course, and it's not the case. Here you have to be really careful because your argument is between minus pi and pi. So you have to divide your region G in two parts. First you take the lower part of your region, and then the next slide we take the upper part. So you get something similar as in question A. You halve the arguments and you get a smaller radius. So this part is mapped to this part over here. And then you take the upper part, which is mapped to this part over here. Try this yourself. And if you combine them, you see your image of your region G now looks like this. So instead of an ice cream, now your image looks like Pac-Man.